Penguin Audio presents Me, written by Ricky Martin, read by Jonathan Davis. God, help me to tell the truth to the strong and to avoid telling lies to get the weak's applause. If you give me fortune, do not take away my reason. If you give me success, do not take away my humility. If you give me humility, do not take away my dignity. God, help me to see the other side of the medal. Don't let me blame others of treason just because they don't think like me. God, teach me to love people as I love myself and to judge me as I judge others. Please, don't let me be proud if I succeed or fall in despair if I fail. Remind me that failure is the experience that precedes triumph. Teach me that forgiving is the most important in the strong, and that revenge is the most primitive sign in the weak. If you take away my success, let me keep my strength to succeed from failure. If I fail people, give me courage to apologize, and if people fail me, give me courage to forgive them. God, if I forget you, please do not forget me. Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhi's words touch my heart. At some point in our lives, all of us ultimately arrive at a moment when we're somehow compelled to look back and consciously reflect on the life we've led. We feel the need to understand where we come from because we want to see with more clarity where we're actually headed and where it is that we really want to go. We search for a way to balance that which we've lived and that which remains for us to experience, with the desire, perhaps, to find a more meaningful purpose to our existence. Some people decide to do this when they're older, closer to the end of their lives. But for me, this moment is right now. Today, I feel the need to look back and observe the path that has led me to where I am, so that the future that lies ahead can be as luminous and truthful as possible. My given name is Enrique Martin Morales, but most people know me as Ricky Martin. Musician, singer, composer, philanthropist, and some might also know I'm an actor. And I am all those things, but I am also a lot more. The people closest to me know me as Kiki, a nickname that comes from Enrique. And aside from being an artist, I'm also a son, a brother, a friend, and most recently a father. For so long, I tried to keep those parts of my life completely separate. When I'm on stage or in front of the cameras, I'm Ricky, but in private, I'm Kiki, a man who each day confronts the challenges of life just like everybody else. While most people hearing this audiobook have a clear sense of who I am as an artist, there's a fundamental part of me that very few really know. Today, after all that I've lived and the many experiences I've been through, I realize that it isn't fair to separate Kiki from Ricky. They're one and the same. It has taken me some time to understand this, and although I used to believe that the best thing would be to hide my personal life and the essence of who I am, now I hold the full conviction that my true happiness lies in living my life freely, without any fears or false pretexts. It has been a gradual process. I can't say exactly when the realization hit me, but I do know that I got to the point where I could no longer live without facing my truth. This is why I've chosen to finally end the secret that I have carefully guarded for so many years. I've decided to tell the world that I accept my homosexuality and celebrate this gift that life has given me. Now, I feel strong, free, more free than ever. Many people probably believe that my life can be broken down into two periods, before and after living la vida loca. Or maybe there are some who think my life is divided between the before and after of my revelation. And the truth is that this is completely understandable. Because until now, that's more or less all I've really shared about myself. And though I won't deny the fact that living la vida loca was a critical moment in my life, I can guarantee that there were many others equally as important to me. There are also the before and after of Menudo, the before and after of my first trip to India, and the before and after of becoming a father. They've all been unique experiences that have impacted me profoundly and altered the way I navigate life. And I hope, I know, that there are many more such moments still to come. Just like everyone else, I've had to walk down my own spiritual path and live through my experiences. The good and the bad, the love and the lack of love, the sense of feeling lost and then finding myself, to arrive at where I am today. Before I could begin to answer the endless questions that were constantly asked of me, I needed to face myself. Of course, some might say I should have done this many years ago, but in the deepest part of my being, I'm certain that the moment is now, because that is how it was always meant to be. It is only now that I am ready, and it is only now that I can do it. Not one day earlier or one day later. The process of writing this memoir hasn't been easy. It has demanded a lot from me, above and beyond what I expected. I've had to tie up loose ends that I'd never attempted to tie up before, to work deeply into memories that were already erased from my mind, and to find answers to very difficult questions. But above all else, above everything, I have finally had to accept myself. I've had to bear myself utterly and completely to see myself exactly as I am. I discovered things that I liked, and others, not as much. And it was precisely the things I didn't like so much that I became intent on remedying from the moment I became conscious of them. I would have never imagined that writing this book would lead me to where it has. However, today I know that I'm a better man and a happier man because of what I've learned about myself throughout the process. I wanted to say a lot in these pages, but I wanted to do it with humility and dignity, focusing on the experiences that have helped shape me. More than an autobiography, this book is a testament of my spiritual beliefs, an account of the steps I've taken to arrive at the place of happiness and completeness where I now find myself. I'll talk about my many personal matters that I've never discussed publicly before, but it isn't my intention to share every little thing either. I believe that we're all entitled to a certain degree of privacy. There are certain things I keep to myself because they're mine alone, and I want them to stay that way. What I would like to do is explore the different paths and experiences that have led me to be the person I am today. I know what it feels like to be loved, and I know what it feels like to love someone, totally and absolutely, with intensity and without any prejudgments. I also know what it's like to be judged for what I am and for what I am not. If I hadn't gone through all of this, maybe I wouldn't have been able to arrive at the moment when I finally understood that my chosen path was the right one, since it has made me into the person I am today. That person I've created with so much effort and dedication is, second to my children, my most precious work. I'm certain that there are many more steps left for me to take, many more things to experience, and therefore many chapters left to write. But right now, I just want to open my heart to you and share my story and this moment of my life with the world. During this time, I've learned that it's useless to label things as either good or bad. The key is to see everything as a lesson. Good and bad alike are both part of a whole, and we have to embrace that whole to reach the complete existence we long for. We advance on certain paths where opportunities come our way, and every step not only gets us closer to where we want to go, but also has a reason for being. Life gives us experiences, and every decision we make determines where we will be later. From the day we're born until the day we die, we progress on a path of learning in which every decision we make or fail to make becomes a part of our personal growth. There's this karmic realm where you have to pass through the challenges that life gives you to liberate yourself from that which weighs you down, preventing you from reaching divinity. We all progress down a spiritual path that offers us opportunities to learn, and even tragedy has its meaning. When you're a student, You have to study the lesson until you know it by heart. And if you don't know it, you don't graduate. In the same way, life presents us with experience after experience. And with every...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.